Good day, everyone, and welcome back to TMac FPV, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. Yes, you may have heard, I've gone pro. Well, I've made the switch to the Jumper T16 Pro. I switched because it has all the features I need and want, such as an internal multi-protocol module, external bay for either Crossfire or my R9M module, more switches, and therefore more versatility in programming modes and adjustments in Betaflight than my QX7, and it has adjustable gimbals too, which is a bonus. But what really convinced me to make the switch was the fact that OpenTX is going to be supporting firmware updates of the T16 officially, beginning soon, most probably with OpenTX version 2.3.2. However, to date, the T16s which Jumper has shipped out don't contain the bootloader which is required to update the T16 with the OpenTX firmware once the official release does occur. So, if you've received a Jumper T16 without the bootloader, which I believe is basically everyone so far, you're going to need to install it first before you can update the T16 with OpenTX versions. That's why today I'm going to demonstrate just how to do that, and I'll update my own T16 with the latest firmware. I'm going to be doing so using procedures developed by Mr. Ben Lai, who goes by Benzo99 on RC Groups. Thank you, Mr. Lai. If you're on the RC Groups forum, I've placed a link in the video description below to his process I'll be using, and if you're not on RC Groups, I've got a T16 bootloader and firmware update checklist down there as well, which you can download through the link provided. Before I go any further, though, I wanted to say a special thank you to the OpenTX devs for working with Jumper and developing the necessary code to make these firmware updates available to all of us. If you'd like to support further OpenTX development, you can do so through a link which I've also provided in the video description below under the heading Resources and Links mentioned in this video. The first thing we need to do, though, is to make a wiring harness for the connection between a USB to serial adapter and the internal multi-protocol module of the T16 Pro. So let's get started. All right now what I'm going to do is make the wiring harness, which goes from the USB to serial adapter to the T16 internal module. We're going to start by tinning the wires. We need to make sure that we connect these wires up to the adapter such that the connection is proper for our connector going in to the internal module. Please pay no attention to the colors of these wires because your wire colors may be different, and I'll go ahead and post a diagram of what each of the wire colors mean in the video here on the screen. But as I go ahead through this, just note that for my colors, the green wire here is going to be for the boot, and the white wire is going to be for the 3.3 volts. And those two wires we want to connect together. So I'm going to solder the green and the white together. The black wire is going to be ground for both the adapter and the internal module. The red wire is going to go to the TX pad of the adapter, and this connector is going to connect the red wire to the RX pad of the internal module, whereas the yellow wire is going to go to the RX pad of the adapter, which when connected to the internal module is going to be connected to the TX pad of the internal module. So that's my coloring scheme. Your coloring scheme may be different, and I'll go ahead and post what each one of these wire colors mean in the video. Okay, at this point we want to go to this URL from Mr. Ben Lai to download and install Flash Multi. It's an application for flashing pre-compiled firmware to a Jumper, iRange X, Vantec, Banggood, or DIY multi-protocol TX module. A GUI app is available for Windows and a shell script for Linux and Mac OS. So once again, thank you, Mr. Ben Lai. So we're going to download and install Flash Multi. He says there are just three steps required to update your Jumper. Download and install Flash Multi, download the appropriate multi-protocol firmware file, and then flash the new firmware to your module. So we're going to go ahead and use Mr. Ben Lai's procedures here and download and install Flash Multi. So we download the latest installer from the releases page. Click there. Mr. Ben Lai released this 13 days ago, version 0.2.2, latest release. Downloads. It's a standalone portable Windows version, or you can get the full Windows installer package, which is what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to do the .exe file. It's downloading over here, and that's going to be 0.2.2. Flash multi, paste, and I'm going to execute this for Windows installation. I'm going to say run anyway. And we love the Flash Multi Setup Wizard. I accept. Here's the agreement. General public license. Next. I'm going to put it under my program files. Next. It's going to create a shortcut, Flash Multi, and install. It says the Flash Multi installer only installs USB and DFU mode drivers for the native Maple serial port, if they are selected. If your version of Windows requires additional serial port drivers for your multi-protocol module, you will need to install those manually and see the Flash Multi documentation for further information. So if this isn't going to work on your particular computer, then you may need to install some different drivers, but go ahead and see this Flash Multi documentation for more information. I'm just going to click Next. And setup has finished installing Flash Multi on our computer. The app may be launched by selecting the installed shortcuts. Finish exit to setup. We're going to click finish. And now we have downloaded and installed Flash Multi. Our next step in the process is to download our latest firmware for the module. And we do that by going to this URL up here by Pascal Langer for DIY multi-protocol TX module. And according to Ben's process, what we want to do is we want to go down to the STM OpenTX AETR, but we want the no INV version .bin. So the latest version of that, these are all TX Flash, USB, Ersky. So we want OpenTX, and my radio, my models are set up with an AETR channel order. You want to make sure and download the correct channel order for your models that you've set up in your T16. And the channel order that I've got set up is AETR. So that's the first step, is we want multi-STM, OpenTX, AETR for me, but we also want the no invert or no INV latest version, which is this one. So I'm going to click here. It downloads it over here, and I've already got a folder set up for that, DIY multi-protocol TX module, and I'm going to paste it here. And that's where it's going to be when we use our Flash Multi to upload this version of the firmware. All right, the next thing we want to do is to make sure that we have a model created in our Jumper T16, which has the internal RF module set to on. So I've got my Ascent 3 HD created here in the T16, and I'm just going to scroll up to show you that we've got the internal module set to on. Internal RF module, mode, multi, FR Sky, D16. And if I scroll down, I'll show you that the external module here, external RF mode, is set to off. So this Ascent 3 HD model in my T16 is the one we're going to use when we turn the radio on and update our firmware. Okay, our next step is to open up the radio and connect our wiring adapter to the internal module. And we have 6 screws that we need to remove. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, now with all 6 screws removed, we gently remove the back cover from the T16. And this right here is your internal multi-protocol module. We're going to join this connector here. And once again, we want to make sure our connections are proper, which I've verified. So we make this connection. And then what we want to do is connect the battery. We're going to turn the radio on.
Welcome to Jumper TX. and we're going to make sure that our model with the internal module turned on is loaded. And as I previously mentioned, that would be our Ascent 3 HD, which you see here, it is loaded. So with that, we just need to connect the adapter to the computer, launch the flash multi-application, select the correct COM port and the firmware file, which we previously saved onto the computer, and click the upload button. We'll go ahead and do that next. Okay, at this point, we turn the radio on and make sure the model is fully loaded. Which it is. We've got the Ascent 3 HD loaded on our T16 with the internal module turned on. I've got the adapter connected to the USB cable here and connected to a USB hub. So all I have to do is turn the USB hub on. And with that, you can see the adapter turns on with this red light. Then it goes out. And from there, we just launch the flash multi, select the COM port and the firmware file, and click the upload button. Now we launch our flash multi. We select the file that we saved for our firmware update right here. We select a port, COM7, upload. Multi-module updated successfully. Okay, at this point, with the multi-module updated successfully, we turn the radio off and disconnect the adapter from the internal module, and then turn the radio back on and check the firmware version of the internal module. We disconnect the module. So now with the USB adapter no longer connected to the transmitter, we've turned the radio on and we've got our Ascent 3 HD loaded. Now we're going to check the firmware version of the transmitter module. What I want to show you though is when you go to radio setup and you go to the version, it's still showing the same version that we had originally, Jumper TX T16 2.3.0 dated 8/27/19. That's not the case for what we just accomplished. We need to go back out of the radio setup menu and instead go into the model settings. So we're going to go into our Ascent 3 HD model settings and take a look at the internal multi-protocol module firmware version that it's using. So to do that, we scroll up and we go to the internal module which it's using, internal RF mode multi FR Sky D16, but in this case the module status now is V1.2.1.85, which is the firmware version that we just uploaded using Flash Multi. So it worked. We are good to go. And that's how you update your T16 with the bootloader necessary for your firmware upgrades.
Now, after you've done the bootloader installation once, subsequent firmware updates with official OpenTX releases can be done just as easily as with previous OpenTX firmware updates. I hope you found this useful, and if so, make sure to share it with your friends. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe for future TMac FPV videos, and check out my website at tmacfpv.com. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.